Amen. And dealing with faith that pleases God allows us to understand God's love and acceptance. And understanding that, we can see that we can approach God without fear and trembling. And so understanding that the faith that I'm in is not a faith that a denominational faith. It's not a faith of an organization or a club or a group. This faith has to do with what God has initiated, which is in Christ Jesus. Because that faith that is in Christ draws us, what, to God, as we said earlier. So let's take a look at this. It says, so then, we're talking about Colossians chapter 2, verse 6. He says, so then, just as you have received, just as you received Christ Jesus as Lord. Now, just as you received him as Lord, continue to live your lives in him. So just as we receive Christ as Lord, how did we receive him? How did we receive him? Because that's going to determine how we're going to have a relationship with God, is the way we receive Christ. See, because if I receive Christ knowing that he's the Son of God, knowing that he's God, knowing that God has come to what? To deliver me. God has come to save me. God has come to rescue me. God has allowed me to see through this, through Christ, that he's accepted me, that he's dealt with my sin, that he's dealt with my condition, and he has a future and a life for me. So how did I receive him? Did I receive him as Lord? Because if he's Lord, that means he's above my situation. He's above my problems. He's above anything that this world could ever bring against me. He's above death. So did I receive him as Lord? Because the way I received him is the way I'm going to walk in him, the way I'm going to live. So this faith that pleases God has spoken something to us, has already taken place. God has already provided everything that we need pertaining to life and godliness. We understand this, that the provisions were made through the death of Christ, that we can experience it in the life of Christ. So he says, just as you received him as Lord. Did we receive him as Lord? We'll continue to live in him as Lord, that he's conquered your fears. He's conquered death and the grave. Hallelujah. He says, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith. Be strengthened in the faith. Now listen, to be strengthened in the faith, first of all, understanding what the faith is, because this is a past tense. This is the righteousness of faith. So I'm strengthened in the faith that God has finished a work concerning me and him through Christ. So when I receive Christ, I'm receiving the fact that God has finished something, a work that allows me to what? To come near him, to draw closer to him, to be a partaker of this divine nature. That's what I'm being built in, rooted in, and ground in, strengthened in the faith, as you were taught. Amen. And overflowing with what? Thanksgiving. Giving God thanks for all that he has accomplished through Christ. The scripture says that the just shall live by faith. We're living by the fact that God has finished a work through Christ that allows us to experience what? A relationship with him as sons and daughters in this, what, and this kingdom, and the kingdom of his dear son, Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. And let's take a look at this one. Galatians chapter 3, verse 23. It says, before the coming of this faith. Now let's take a look. Now, before the coming of this faith, what faith? The faith that pleases God. Because as we said earlier, the faith that pleases God is the faith that sets us free, the faith that delivers us, the faith that draws us near him. It's a righteousness of faith, that we're no longer slave to sin. We're no longer under the law, This is the faith that pleases God. Until this faith come, before this faith, before the coming of this faith, we were what? What? Held up. Held up. Excuse me. We're not held up. We were held in custody under the law. Locked up until what? The faith that was to come would be what? Revealed. So we were in custody under the law until this faith was what? Revealed. So this is the faith that pleases God. When this faith was revealed, we were set free. For what? Being under the law. Jesus was what? Born under the law to redeem us from the law. He is the faith that showed up. He is the righteousness of faith that showed up. He is the faith of God that showed up. In him. In him. In him is a faith that releases a belief that God is the Almighty God. He's the one that set the captives free. Oh, glory to God. I'm getting excited. So he says, until the faith that was to come be revealed. So the law was our guardian until what? Christ came. You know, I look at this like this here. When I was staying with my parents, my mom had her rules and had her regulations and different things. But I would rebel against some of the things that she wanted me to do, wanted me to follow. I didn't like that stuff. You know, I want to be my own man, do my own thing. I want to be grown, want to be on my own, you know. But the things that she was instilling in me, whether they were through punishment or whether they were through chastisement or whatever it was, you know. But when I got on my own, don't you know, being under her guardianship helped me. I learned some things, and I'm still being reminded of some things that she taught me. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So the law was a schoolmaster, was a guardian until Christ came, until faith came, that we might be what? Justified by faith. So we were justified by this faith. Why? Because through this faith, through this righteousness of faith, it met the expectations of the law. Now see, you're not being released from the law because you're good. You're not being released from the law because you're so kind and so pretty and wonderful. No, no. You're being released from the law is because of God's grace and mercy, because of this great grace that God has lavished on us. He has met the expectations of the law. We're not being released from under the law because of how we act or how we behave. No, 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 no. We are being released and justified by our faith that God makes the expectations of the law. Because the law did what? It condemned us. It revealed what? Our sin, our trespasses. So this faith supplied. This faith supplied our need, a death that we owed, that we could not pay. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Now that this faith has come, we are no longer under what? Guardian. So in Christ Jesus, you are all what? Children of God through faith. We are children of God through this faith. Through this righteousness of faith, we are children of God. I wasn't made a child of God through a denomination, or through a group, or through an organization. We were made a child of God, children of God, through this faith that came in the person of Jesus Christ. That in him, we found God's love and acceptance. He took him to the cross, buried him in the grave, and raised him up. All this has meaning, and we are grounded and rooted in this faith. That God is no longer what counting our sins against us, but we can come near to him and experience a life evermore, everlasting. Oh, hallelujah. This is good news. This is good news, a faith that pleases God. Amen? So let's continue with this study. Now, the scriptures in Romans chapter 3 talks about apart from the law, a righteousness is revealed apart from the law. And verse 22 says, this righteousness is given through faith in Jesus Christ. This righteousness is given through faith in Jesus Christ. When something is given to you, we gotta understand here, This faith has been given to us in Jesus Christ, through faith in Jesus Christ. It's been given. When something has been given to you, it's something that has already occurred. See, the righteousness is given through faith. It's given through faith. It's given through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. So when I receive Christ, I'm being given something that has already occurred. This righteousness is a righteous act of God. It's already occurred. So I'm being given through faith in Christ. I'm being given a righteousness that is through Christ Jesus. This righteousness is given through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. So because I believe in Christ, I am receiving a righteousness that is through faith. Yes, because I believe in Christ, I am given a righteousness that is through faith in Jesus Christ. This righteousness is an act of God, that God has already done something. Something has already occurred. So receiving Christ is receiving an act of God's own righteousness that he is pleased with. Because it draws me near to him, if I can say that, and we get an understanding of that. But he also says, dropping down to verse number 25, it says, God presented Christ as a sacrifice. He presented Christ as a sacrifice of an atonement. Let me talk about the atonement for a moment, because this is a bad translation here. Atonement is covering sins. Jesus did not come to cover sins. He came to take them away. So Jesus, our sacrifice, God presented him as a sacrifice to take away the sins of the world. Through the shedding of his blood, to be what? Received by faith. We have to receive the shedding of Christ's blood by faith. When you receive something by faith, you're receiving it as a past tense. So I'm receiving a past tense by faith that his blood has already accomplished something for me on my behalf. So I'm receiving through the blood of Christ by faith, through the shedding of his blood, that my what? Sins have been dealt with. So to be received by faith, you got to receive his blood by faith that has already done an act already. It's already accomplished something for us. He did this to demonstrate what? His righteousness. So the shedding of his blood was demonstrated to do what? To demonstrate his righteousness. This is God. God's righteousness, because in his forbearance, he had left the sins committed beforehand unpunished. The sins of everybody from Jesus on back to Adam, they were left unpunished. But God demonstrated his righteousness. This is a right act by taking Jesus to the cross and through his blood. So his blood has to be received by faith. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He did it to demonstrate his righteousness at the present time, hallelujah, at the present time, as to be just and the one who justifies those who have what? Faith in Jesus Christ. See, because we have faith in Jesus Christ, we have just received the same act of God's righteousness that was demonstrated long ago, over 2,000 years ago. No, he's not doing it right now. He's already done it. So faith in Christ, we able to what? Receive the faith that pleases God. That what? That he has justified, made right those before Christ and us who have faith in Christ. He demonstrated his righteousness. This is the faith that pleases God. That we're walking in. We're walking in this faith. Oh, that set the captives free. And I want to hit on this because, like I said, we faith is being tossed around so many ways. And how much faith do you have? How big is your faith? Let me tell you, it's not about how much faith you have. How big your faith is. It's how big our God is. He's big enough to draw us to him. He's big enough that he has, what, dealt with every enemy we can ever deal with. He is taking care of us through the person of Christ. God loves me and you. And he has justified us to walk in his courtroom with praise and thanksgiving. He's a loving God. He's a merciful God. So what faith did we respond to? See, because if I'm still trying to be accepted, if I'm still trying to look for God to forgive me, am I still trying to, See, what gospel did we hear? What did we respond to? Because in this gospel of grace, there's no barrier, there's no gap, there's no sin that has not gone unpunished. There's nothing that's in the way of us and God. God loves you just like the way you are, but he won't leave you like you are. Because when we receive him, he's working on the inside of our hearts. Allow us to come to understanding how great his love really is. Amen. Amen. I'm telling you, the faith that pleases God, it's a faith that expresses his love and acceptance. Well, let us conclude with this. There's so much to be said about faith that pleases God. But let's take a look at this scripture here. Hebrews, one of our favorite chapters of the Bible, one of our favorite books of the Bible is Hebrews. Yeah, because it talks about faith. Hebrews 11:1, it says, now faith is confidence and what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. So if we're talking about a faith that pleases God, first of all, and a faith that God initiated and we responded to it, because there is something in Christ that leads us to God. He reveals the Father. He's not talking about himself. And the Spirit of God is giving us understanding and knowledge of him. Jesus says that this is the Spirit of God that's bringing us into the knowledge of who he is, what he represents. It's the Spirit of God that is doing that in our hearts even today. So now faith is confidence. Now faith is confidence. So our faith that pleases God has given us confidence. Faith is confidence in what we hope for. What was revealed to us? We found out that we were what? Sinners, separated from God, dead in our trespasses, in our sins, on our way to a devil's hell, lost, destiny, hell was our destiny. We were going that way. But when we heard the gospel message of a life to be shared, a life to live with God, when we heard of God's love and acceptance, we our hearts leaped, our souls came alive. We reached out. We wanted to participate. We wanted to live this eternal life. We wanted to share in this. So how hope came alive. So hope came alive. So faith is a confidence of the hope that we have. Faith has given us a hope that is in God, for an assurance about what we do not see. Faith has revealed to us that things that we do see was what? Were made by the things that we do not see. What is this we're talking about? This is what the ancients were commended for. That they had a faith. Abraham, Enoch, Abel. You know the story. All those had faith in God. I believe it like this here. By faith, it says Abraham. By faith, Abel. By faith, Enoch. By faith, they understanding something. By faith, they know that God exists. And they accomplish what God has said. By faith, they walked in faith. And we are also living a life in faith. For the just shall live by faith. Faith is our confidence. because God has initiated. And faith is our assurance. And what I'm speaking of is the faith that is in Christ. Faith is not outside of Christ. It's not Jesus in faith. It's not Jesus in tongues. It's not Jesus in prayer. It's not Jesus in all these other things. It is Christ in him alone. We can read it like this here. Now, Jesus is our confidence and what we hope for. And Jesus is our assurance about what we do not see. Amen? Faith is also the word of God. Jesus is the word of God. Amen? Faith that pleases God has been revealed. Jesus is that faith. Have you come unto him to experience God's love and acceptance? You don't have to wait till you get it together. Because what? Because he has already got it together. That's why we receive it by faith. We couldn't receive it by faith if he had not gotten it together. If he had not justified us already. If he had not removed our sins as far as the east from the west already. If he had not forgiven us totally, if he has not made us righteous and holy forever, well, then we can't receive it by faith. The only reason why we can receive it by faith is because it's already done. Because it's already done. You can come to the Lord today because the provision has already been made in Christ. Come to Christ. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for this time that we had today. Hey, share this with friends and family. The faith that pleases God. Let's talk about it. God bless you. See you next time.